There are four major crimes under the Violence Against Women Act: domestic violence, dating violence, sexual assault, and stalking. So how do sexual assault, or sexual violence more broadly, and stalking intersect? Victims who were stalked by an abusive intimate partner were more likely to experience multiple forms of sexual violence than those abused but not stalked, including sexual degradation, substance use, and penetration while sleeping. About 1 in 3 women stalked by an intimate partner were also sexually assaulted by that partner. And about half of sexual assault survivors said they experienced stalking as well. Well, remember that stalking is a pattern of behavior directed at a specific person that would cause a reasonable person to feel fear for their safety or the safety of others, or to suffer substantial emotional distress. So, fear or emotional distress about what? Many stalking victims and survivors are afraid of sexual violence. In fact, while stalking statutes vary across the country, most include fear of sexual violence. Every category of stalking behavior: surveillance, life invasion, intimidation, and interference through sabotage or attack, can include tactics that are sexually violent in nature. Surveillance behaviors may include voyeurism, whether in person or by accessing or planting recording devices. Surveillance may also include gathering information about the victim, either through technology, asking mutual acquaintances, or other means. That information might include researching and selecting victims based on their perceived vulnerabilities, disabilities, or lack of credibility, or finding out when a chosen victim is alone or isolated to commit the sexual violence. Stalkers may also gather information for later blackmail or extortion, or the monitoring might happen after the violence to see if the victim is telling anyone about what has happened. Stalkers may also engage in life invasion, showing up in the victim's life when the victim doesn't want them to be there, through leaving sexual items or gifts, excessive contact of a sexual nature, and or spreading sexual rumors or information about a victim to others. Many stalkers intimidate their victims through both direct and indirect threats. These could be threats to share sexual images or information, engaging in symbolic sexual violence like cutting underwear or stealing intimate items, threatening to sexually harm the victim or those the victim cares about, or coercing or threatening the victim into sexual acts. Interference through sabotage or attack may include tampering with or stealing birth control, posting or sharing intimate images of the victim, spreading sexual rumors, impersonating a victim online to set them up for sexual violence, or actually committing a sexual attack. When you're working with a victim of sexual violence or intimate partner violence, be sure to ask about stalking victimization. To get started, visit coercivecontrol.org for a risk assessment specific to stalking that creates a narrative report and safety planning suggestions. Advise victims to keep a documentation log to keep track of every stalking incident. Make sure to include stalking in your safety planning and consider stalking charges when appropriate. Visit stalkingawareness.org for safety planning guidance, tips for law enforcement, more information on stalking and sexual violence, brochures, and so much more. Together, we can better identify co-occurring victimizations to keep stalking victims safe and hold offenders accountable.